Hello folks, and welcome back to the shop. It's Wednesday morning now, and I've been filming during the last days just a couple of clips because I really haven't had anything really interesting to share with you. So I will just post the clips after this clip right here to make up one video. A huge amount of stuff has happened. I'm doing lots of work every day. There's these aluminum pieces are milled out. The ends are milled out. And this will be some aluminum crowbars which I have made since I started my full-time business. And the tips are now milled. And of course I will next have to turn the shank, and for that I have to center drill the end and make a tiny radius at the end so it's not sharp. So I have done this on the manual lathe, but I think from now on I will do it on the CNC lathe. So we will see that set up soon, hopefully. And yesterday I made some of these parts. Nothing special about them. Just a simple piece of 10x50 aluminum. And some holes drilled and tapped. And a place for a M6. Screw head, 16 of those, and then I got, which I also have some clips about, I got the Casto automatic hacksaw working completely, so the automatic feeding system is now working, and that is just so awesome. And what I actually did to it, nothing, I just probably learned how to use it. So most probably all the time until now it has been an operator error. Well, it still has one problem which actually has occurred in my time. When I got this machine it still worked, but not anymore. So I can only open this vise. I cannot close it from the switch. But luckily when I switch on the cycle, it will close on itself, so that's pretty good, but it's still something that I have to fix. And what else? Just a moment. Well, let me show you a little bit of a nasty thing. Well, very much of a nasty thing. It seems that my oil burner's been going on all night. Even though it's not supposed to be on. So, I just came here and I set fire to the wood burning stove. And I was surprised to find that the water still hadn't cooled down completely during the night, even though it was really cold, and I think I didn't even get the water temperature high yesterday. So the reason was that it looks like the oil burner's been going on all night. I have the temperature set to about 30 degrees, so yesterday I didn't notice that it was still on, but actually just a minute ago when I was filming, I was surprised that the oil burner came on, and I had even left the hatch open. So, well, a few liters of oil wasted maybe. Well, it all goes to heating the building, of course, but I really didn't want to waste any more or use any more oil because we are so low on it. So anyways, now it's set off. So let's get back what I was saying. next is what I'm doing at the moment, which is pretty interesting, I think. It's CNC work, but I think you will like it. Take a look at this part. It's an aluminum part with threads cut on a ball insert, so it has a 4 mm diameter or 2 mm radius insert that I do the grooves, I mean the threads with, and the pitch is 4 mm. And I think this came out, or this come out pretty good. They still have to have a hole drilled through and tapped with M8 threads, and I will do that on the manual lathe. So you can see my progress. These are all scrap pieces. Actually, two of them were supposed to be okay. I think they're these ones. But then I re-looked at the drawing, and I had misread the tolerance on one of the parts. And these were just a little bit undersized, so I had to make more. Luckily, it's not a huge waste of material or time anyways. So starting from this piece, which has some really bad issues with pretty much everything, vibration in grooving, and pretty crude looking threads, and bent over edges in the face and whatnot, going to these pieces, which I'm really happy with now. So let me show you how I run these parts. Okay, this is the last part that I can make from this stock. It's getting short. So the stick out is 55 mm, and this is a 30 mm bar of 6182 aluminum. So let's go. And this is a left hand tool, so the lathe has to change the turning direction or the rotating dimension each time it switches to that tool. Some initial grooves, and then for the thread. It is doing it in 10 passes. I'm taking it really slow. And I'm using a reduced infeed, so it's taking less each pass. It's not taking long. It's running at 500 RPM. And the actual carriage moving speed is 2 meters per minute when it's feeding or threading. So I would say it's pretty fast threading. And now, after the threads, it's finishing the face. And the coolant nozzle is a little bit blocked on this tool holder. I should fix that. And refinishing the OD of the thread and roughing off the backside. Roughing at really rough beads. I think it's a 0.55 or like 22 thousandths per revolution feed for roughing. And then finishing the grooves. Using a kind of a side-to-side technique. And there's a little bit of a flaw in the program. It's homing itself for two times unnecessarily. There's another homing for nothing. And then I'm just using my hand to catch the pot. And I know this is a little bit hazardous. Don't do this. But I am staying away from the chalk. And the reason I do that is because I don't want the piece to fall on the floor, and also I don't want to leave it on just a little bit and then rock it out, because when the tool pulls out, it leaves some marks on this face if the part is still on the piece, on the bar, I mean. So it's a little bit hazardous, but it's the best way to get the best parts, and I don't really see it any dangerous. I'm staying away from the chalk. So this is the fifth and the last part. So pretty happy about those. And I did spend quite a few moments trying to figure out how to cut these. And I had to make many, many tiny little changes to the program. But I think it paid off. So I only have 5 of these to make. So it's not really that great of a deal to do on a CNC lathe, but it's still such a complicated piece that I think I would have used just as much time on the manual machine, and the end result would not have been as good as on the CNC. And I have to say, I really enjoy using the CNC lathe, because I still don't know a whole lot about it, and I'm still learning every day when I use it. Whereas on the VMC, I would like to say that I pretty much know this machine inside and out now. So it's not giving me such a joy anymore, because the learning curve it's not so steep anymore. Of course, I'm learning each day, but on the lathe, I'm learning just so much more each day when I use it. So, anyways, I think that's the end of this clip, and after this clip, I'm gonna attach the other clips that I filmed during the last couple of days. And pretty much the next work that I'm gonna have is really boring. I'm gonna make a few hundreds of small aluminum parts, so that's not gonna be very interesting. So I might show some of that to you, but I know you won't be liking that too much, so maybe you should not expect videos from me in a couple of days. Maybe I will get back to you next week, but rest of this week's work is pretty boring, so I will get back to you when I have something interesting to share. So I will attach the rest of the clips here, and right now I will say thanks for watching, and until next time. Hello, folks. So for some unknown reason, the saw seems to now work completely, including the automatic feeding system. So I have a thin aluminum stock as a test piece. So let's see how it works. It's raising the blade all the way up. You can adjust that by adjusting the position of a micro switch. So it's way too high at the moment, so I have to push this down by hand. Let me show you another cut. I think it's pretty cool. Now it's coming back down. This is the last piece. Feeding pretty slow, almost as slow as it will go, and that's the way I like to keep it. That's it, switches itself down. So seems to be working just as it should now. And this is very, very weird. And because I really didn't do anything to it. Well, I think after all it might just have been an operator error. Because I haven't been sure how to activate the automatic mode. But I accidentally probably found a way how to do it, and the way is that you have to have everything ready for sewing, and you have to have these movable vise against the left side stop, and then you just push start, and this is not the automatic start, this is the manual start, and then you switch to the automatic cycle. Whoops, it doesn't have any. Okay, now it has 5, so you can hear some relays clicking, and now it's on automatic. That's pretty cool. So really happy about that. And right now it's especially good because probably tomorrow I'm gonna have some large pipe which I'm gonna have to sew like 30 pieces off, and it's gonna take a while. So it would be really great if the saw could do it. Could do it all on its own. Okay, looks like this is kind of another one of those a little bit of this and that videos. So about the weather today, it's freaking cold. It's like -5 or 6 degrees, or at least it was in the morning, but it's still freezing. So it's pretty cold. I guess the winter is coming. And all of the aluminum milling is now done. And the pieces came out pretty good. Quite a few chips on the floor. And actually, since it's the first real cold day, I'm also running the heating system for the first time. Sometimes a little bit difficult to get the exhaust smoke ventilation working. So in other words, the smoke wants to push in if I'm just using the wood stove. But when I switch on the oil burner, that usually helps because it's forcing air through the chimney, and it somehow gets the air moving. Seems like everything is working fine. Temperature is a little bit over 20 degrees Celsius now. Or about 25. And a little bit under 20 here. And the oil burner seems to produce heat a little bit faster than the wood stove. Especially when the wood stove is just started. But the oil burner is making heat from the moment that it's switched on. We're running pretty low on oil. We only have like 4% left. Can you see anything? So we're still thinking on whether or not to buy more oil, because we have a lot of wood, and we now have 3 heat pumps in our house like this. 2 upstairs and this one downstairs. So they should actually be enough to heat the whole house. And for example, the water that we used to use in the shower, for example, the warm water is coming from this electric heater, which I have fixed once. So we don't really need oil for anything anymore.
No niin, ne puree tolleen, toisin ne mukaan puremaan. Ne mukaan puremaan.
Eikös kannusteta tämän?
Tuuri katsoa, että tää ei oo kyllä nyt se leikki, mitä mä oon niinku mukana. Täytyy ihan eri suuntaan.